Good afternoon, children. Welcome to YouTube online classes. As we are learning about different types of animal tissues from our last few classes, today we are going to discuss about the epithelial tissues in this class. The types of epithelial tissue. The epithelial tissue where they are present in the body and the functions of epithelial tissues. These are all the concepts we are going to discuss today. Here is our biological science teacher, K. Adavi Ramudu sir, school assistant biological science, ZBHS VN Puram, Suryapet district, is associated with us. You can share your views and you can ask questions after completion of the class. Okay, welcome Adavi Ramudu sir, and take the class. Thank you very much.
Good morning, children. Today we are learning about the animal tissues. First we are taking the living organisms means life having organisms are called living organisms. These living organisms are two types, that are, first one is the plants, next second one is the animals. Plants and animals, both are the living organisms. So this plant body composed with cells, and also animal body also composed with cells. So the cells are the structural unit of the living organisms, because that makes the body, living organisms body. Now we take the animal body. So animal body also composed with which one? Cells. So on the basis of the number of cells, animals are two types, that are, first one is the unicellular animals, second one is the multicellular animals. Unicellular animals means these are composed with single cell, only one cell. Multicellular organisms means these are composed with many cells, number of cells. So here many cells are there. So this type of animals are called multicellular animals. So what are the example for unicellular animals? Protozoans are example for unicellular. In the protozoa, amoeba, euglena, next paramecium. So these are the protozoans. This body composed with only one cell. These are the unicellular animals. Multicellular animals, except protozoans, remaining animals are the multicellular animals. In this, tissues are present. In this, tissues are absent, because only one cell is there. Tissue means a group of cells. That's why in this tissues are present. In this group of cells are absent, only one cell is there. So in this tissues are absent. Now what is the tissue? We are taking the tissue. What is the meaning of the tissue? Tissue means a group of cells. a group of cells. So these are the cells. Here many cells are there. A group of cells that are structurally and functionally similar. So that is called a tissue. A group of cells that are structurally and functionally similar, that is the tissue. Here a group of cells are there, many cells are there. So these cells are structurally same, all cells are in a round shape. Next, for example, these are functional. All cells are uniquely performs the protection. For example, protection. So this function is the protection. So structurally similar and functionally similar. So this is the tissue. Next, for example, another one. So these are the cells. These are in a pillar shape. All cells are. This one is the cell. This one is all cells. A group of cells that are structurally similar, structurally pillar shape, and functionally, for example, this function is the secretion. So functionally similar, all cells uniquely perform the secretion. All cells are structurally similar, means pillar shape. So this is the another kind of tissue. So this is the definition for tissue. Tissue means a group of cells that are structurally and functionally similar, that is the tissue. So animal body contain four types of tissue. Our body also, we are example for multicellular fishes, multicellular animals, reptiles, amphibians, insects, except protozoans, all other birds also multicellular. In this four types of tissues are there. So animal body contain four types of tissues that are, first one is epithelial tissue. Next, second one is the connective tissue. Next, third one is the muscular tissue. Fourth one is the nervous tissue. So four types of tissues in the animal body: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue, nervous tissue. So every tissue perform the specific function. For example, here epithelial tissue, this function protection, this is helps in our protection, secretion and absorption. So connective tissue, this function connect the internal organs. Muscular tissue, this function movement, this use the movement to the body. Fourth one, nervous tissue, this is conduct the information from organs to brain and brain to organs. This is the function of the nervous tissue. So every tissue has specific function. So in an animal body, how many types of tissues? Four types: epithelial, connective tissue, muscular tissue, nervous tissue. Now we taking the epithelial tissue. Now we are learning about the epithelial tissue. Now epithelial tissue. Epi. At first we take the epi. Epi means outer. Epi means outer. Thelial means to develop tissue. epithelial tissue means, epi means outer, thelial means to develop. Here epithelial tissue covers the total body of animals covers that. So this is the covering tissue. This is also covers the internal organs, heart, lungs, internal organs, kidneys. These are the internal organs. Next, this is covers the inner space of the tube-like structures. What are tube-like structure? Esophagus. So this is the esophagus. This is connect the stomach and mouth. Esophagus, tube-like structure. In this inner space covers with epithelial tissue. And also blood vessels. Inner space covers with epithelial tissue. This is the meaning of the epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue, covering tissue. It covers the total body of animals. It covers the internal organs of the animals. And also covers the inner space of tube-like structures. Now, epithelial tissue functions. Epithelial tissue function. First, absorption. First one is the absorption. Next one is the protection. This is helps in protection. Next, secretion. It secretes the enzymes in stomach and intestine. So these are the functions of the epithelial tissue. On the basis of the shape. On the basis of the function, shape and function, the epithelial tissues are many types. Here five types are there. First one is the squamous epithelial tissue. Squamous epithelial tissue. Next, second one, cuboidal epithelial tissue. Third one, columnar epithelial tissue. Fourth one, ciliated epithelial tissue. Fifth one, glandular epithelial tissue. Total five types are there. First one, squamous epithelial tissue. Second one, cuboidal. Third one, columnar. Fourth one, ciliated. Fifth one, glandular epithelial tissue. One by one. Squamous epithelial tissue. So this is one kind of epithelial tissue. In this, the cells are, this is the basement membrane. In the epithelial tissue character, this is the, so in this basement layer is present, basement membrane. On this, the cells are arranged compactly, in this way, compactly. Next, these are the cells of the squamous epithelial tissue, squamous. So this one is the nucleus. So squamous epithelial tissue structure, first structure, the cells are flat and forms the extremely thin layer. Next, they are arranged compactly, very closely. So in this intercellular spaces absent. Intercellular spaces means the gap. For example, your cells, these are the cells. The space between the cells, this one is the cell, total five cells are there. A space is there. So the space is called intercellular spaces. So these intercellular spaces are absent because the cells are arranged compactly, very closely. So in this intercellular spaces are absent. Structure once again, squamous epithelial tissue. This one is the squamous. In this, the cells are flat and forms the extremely thin layer. Second one, cells are arranged compactly. So in this intercellular spaces are absent. Now these cells are arranged on basement membrane. So this one is the basement membrane. This is the structure of the squamous. On the basis of the number of layers, the squamous epithelial tissue, two types. First one is the simple squamous epithelial tissue. Second one is the stratified epithelial tissue. Sorry, squamous epithelial tissue. Simple and stratified. Both are the types of the squamous on the basis of the number of layers. First, simple. In this, first basement membrane, this is on this. The cells are arranged in a single row. So this is the simple squamous epithelial tissue. Next, second one is the stratified. This is the basement membrane. Next, on this, the cells are arranged in many rows. Second row, and this one is the third row. Three rows or many rows. So this one is the stratified squamous epithelial tissue. In this, the cells are arranged in a single row. In this, the cells are arranged in many rows, stratified. So location of the simple epithelial tissue. Simple squamous epithelial tissue location. So this location, lining of mouth. So this is the mouth cavity. This mouth cavity covers with which one? Simple squamous epithelial tissue. Next, second one, esophagus. This is the tube-like structure. Lining of esophagus means this is the esophagus. So this one is the esophagus. This one is the stomach. This one is the esophagus. Lining means inner space covers with. This is the inner space. So this inner space covers with which one? Simple squamous. Lining of esophagus. Third one, lining of blood vessels. So these are also blood vessels, also tube-like structure. This one is the blood vessel. So this inner space also covers with simple spines. Next one is the fourth one, lungs alveoli. Next to fifth one, Bowman's capsule. Next to last one, capillary walls. So in these places, this tissue is present in simple squamous epithelial tissue. Here also, this is present at the where the transportation of substances selectively occurs through the permeable membrane. In that places, this tissue is present. So where this is occurs at the lungs alveoli, Bowman's capsule and capillary walls. In these places, substances transport through the which one permeable membrane. So these are in these places this tissue is present. Simple squamous epithelial tissue. Next one is the second one, stratified epithelial tissue. Stratified squamous epithelial tissue. Squamous epithelial tissue. Stratified means in this the cells are arranged in many rows. So this one is the one row, this one is the another row. So many layers are there. This is the stratified. This location in our skin. This is present at the skin. This is the location of the stratified. Why in the skin? Many layers are present. Reason is that this is protect the internal organs. Protect the internal organs from temperature. Means heat. Heat. And it protects the internal organs from injuries. And also germs. Because of this reason, in the skin many layers are present. So this skin forms the nails. Next, the second one, hairs, horns, hooves. These are grow from which one? Skin. And also scales of fishes. Scales of fishes and reptiles. The reptiles means snakes. Reptiles examples are the snakes. In the fishes and in the reptiles, the skin covers with the scales. So the scales developing from each one skin. Next one is the feathers. Feathers of birds. So these feathers also grow from skin. So in this, what types of cells are present? In the nails, hairs, horns, hooves, scales, and feathers. Modified epithelial cells are present. Modified epithelial cells are present in these. This is about the squamous epithelial tissue. This one is the first one. In the epithelial tissue, first one is the squamous epithelial tissue. Next, second one is the cuboidal epithelial tissue. In this same, the epithelial tissue, the cells are arranged on the basement membrane. That is important. Now, structure of the cuboidal epithelial tissue. First, basement membrane. This one is the basement membrane. Next, the cells. So these are the cells. The cells are cube shape. So this one is the nucleus. This one, basement membrane. Next to these are cells, epithelial cells. So this is the structure of the cuboidal epithelial tissue structure points. First one, the cells are in a cube shape. Cube shape means this one. This type of shape, cube shape. Length and width, both are same. Length and width, both are same. So that shape is the cuboid, cube shape. In this, the cells are arranged compactly. Compactly means very closely. Compactly means in this, what are absent? Intercellular spaces are absent. Intercellular spaces. Next, the cells are arranged on the which membrane? So this is the membrane. The membrane is basement membrane. This is about the structure of the cuboidal epithelial tissue. Location of the cuboidal epithelial tissue. Location. Location. This is present at the kidney tubes. Kidney tubes. Next, second one. Salivary glands. Salivary glands. In these places, this tissue is present. Cuboidal epithelial tissue. This is location. Kidney tubes and salivary glands. And also, this tissue provide the mechanical support to the salivary glands. This is the cuboidal epithelial tissue. Next, third epithelial tissue. Third one. Third epithelial tissue. Columnar. Columnar epithelial tissue. Columnar epithelial tissue. This structure. Now, first basement membrane. This is the basement membrane. So on this, the cells are arranged compactly. These are the columnar cells, epithelial cells. Columnar epithelial cells. Epithelial cells. First, this is the structure of the epithelial, columnar epithelial cells. First point. In this, the cells are very tall. Very tall and pillar shaped. Really, very tall and pillar shaped. Next, the cells are arranged compactly. Compactly. So, intercellular spaces are absent. Intercellular spaces are absent. Next, these cells are arranged on basement membrane. Basement membrane. So this is the basement membrane. This is the structure of the columnar epithelial tissue. This location, this tissue location, location. Which organelles are? Which organelles are? Involved in, which organelles are involved in absorption and secretion, absorption and secretion in these places, what is present? Columnar epithelial tissue. So where the secretion occurs in our body or in animal body, in our stomach, and in the intestine. In these places, secretion occurs. So these are secretes the enzymes. So digested food materials are absorbed in intestine. So in these two places, what type of tissue is present? Columnar epithelial tissue. In these places, what is occurs? Absorption and secretion. Example, stomach and intestine. This is about the columnar. Next, fourth one is the ciliated epithelial tissue. So in the same, this is the basement membrane. On this, the cells are arranged compactly. So these are the cells. compactly, intercellular spaces are absent. This is the free surface of the cell. This is the cell, many cells. So this is the free surface of the cell. So the free surface of the cells contain air-like projections. So these air-like projections are called cilia. So in this, what are present? Cilia. Ciliated epithelial tissue. So these cells bears the cilia. So what is the function of the ciliated epithelial tissue? So this is performs the movement of substances. So this is the function of the ciliated epithelial tissue. This again, the free surface of the cells contain air-like projections that are called cilia. So these are helps in movement of substances. This is the ciliated epithelial tissue. Now last one, that is the glandular epithelial tissue. Glandular epithelial tissue, this is the modified epithelial tissue, and this is the specific epithelial tissue. Some portions are, for example, this one is the epithelial tissue, total this is the epithelial tissue. This is the portion of the epithelial tissue. So the some portions of epithelial tissue get folded inwards and forms the multicellular glands. These are crossed with many cells, multicellular glands. So this type of tissue is called which one? Glandular epithelial tissue. Glandular means some portions of the epithelial tissue get folded inwards and forms the multicellular glands. This type of tissue is the glandular epithelial tissue. This is stores the chemical substances means the hormones. So this location at the glands, this one is the glandular epithelial tissue. So once again, recapitulation, here animal body contain total four types of tissues: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue, nervous tissue. Next, epithelial tissue, five types on the basis of the function and shape. Five types, that are: first one, squamous epithelial tissue. Second one, cuboidal epithelial tissue. Third one, columnar epithelial tissue. Fourth one, ciliated epithelial tissue. Last one, glandular epithelial tissue. So these are the types of the epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue, main important points are cells arranged compactly. In all these, the cells are arranged compactly, very closely. Intercellular spaces are absent. In all these, intercellular spaces are absent. Next, cells arranged on basement membrane. Next, in these two types are there, on the basis of the number of layers. First one, simple squamous epithelial tissue. Second one,